Good morning, good morning, and good morning. We're here at your Cleveland Metro Park Zoo. Sounds of progress happening here. That's why Travis is here to talk to us about it. So, I mean, lots of construction going on here, Travis.
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, welcome to Susie's Bear Hollow.
Wow, where's Susie? She out there working? She's got a hard hat on.
Well, we're at is actually standing right inside one of the main bear exhibits we're going to be making.
So I'm looking for bears. So
yeah,
no bears here right now.
No bears right here.
Because I see no fences.
No fences yet.
Okay,
yeah,
that's good.
A little premature for that.
Yeah.
So there's going to be four spaces here.
Okay.
And this is 50 years in the making.
Wow.
So, you know, we've learned a lot about how to best take for bears in the last 50 years.
Right.
But what was here previously and the knowledge we have has outpaced, you know, what we know now.
Definitely.
So very dynamic changes we're going to be making.
Okay.
Like I said, four spaces.
So when you say four spaces for the bears to go or four spaces for us?
Yeah, four spaces for the bears.
Okay.
Also some prime viewing right here, what you're seeing
right
here.
So we'll be able to go in there.
That is public viewing in there.
Ah, okay.
And this is housing Andean bears.
Huh.
And sloth bears.
Oh, no way.
Very dynamic species.
You aren't kidding.
Sloth bears, very gregarious species. They're from India.
Okay.
And then Andean bears are South American. So
very,
very exciting.
Four areas. I see some structure going on over there.
Yep.
So each bear will have two, or will they be interchangeable? How will that work?
Interchangeable.
Okay.
So very much like our philosophy in Roseboro's Tiger Passage,
right,
where we have different spaces for the animals to experience.
Okay.
Interchangeable. On one day, they can be in one space to have this perspective. On another day, they'll be in another space to have that perspective.
So that kind of mixes it up for them, too.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, it won't be so boring.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, how much space are we talking about? Because where we're standing here will not be where the people can stand.
Yeah, right.
So how much, because I can see, Lamont, if you can go all the way to the end there, it looks like it kind of wraps all the way around, does it?
Yes, it wraps all the way around. Where we're at is in Wilderness Trek at the zoo here.
All right.
It's on the backside of Roseboro Tiger Passage.
Yep.
And this is about three times the space for the bears that what was here previously.
Okay.
So everybody's come to the zoo and saw the old traditional moated exhibits.
Mm-hmm.
That's about three times greater than what it was.
Oh, that's going to be amazing.
Yes, absolutely.
Which is why we can have a few more bears.
Absolutely, yeah. Our goal is to of course, expand our bear collection here and really do right by those two species.
Mm-hmm.
Exciting features is the climbing and foraging opportunities and digging. Nesting and all those features.
So it's a bear Disneyland.
Bear Disneyland. All the accoutrements they can imagine. We think about and think about natural behaviors and what do bears like to do.
And they'll be able to do it. Mm-hmm. Well, this is so awesome. So as we wrap up, no crystal ball, but hopefully we'll be done-ish when, Travis?
We're thinking about in the June neighborhood.
Ish.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to say ish. That leaves you alone. All right. When we come back, lots to talk about. Thank you so much, Travis.
Thank you.
Lots to talk about at your Cleveland Metro Park Zoo. Kicking it with Kenny today with us.